Hello everyone, I'm John Louis, your memory coach. You are welcome to my YouTube channel, John at 1960. Today we are going to learn 10th standard chemistry carbon compounds part 1. To begin with, let us quickly revise 1 mark questions for board examination from carbon compounds chapter. Our first question is, what is a covalent bond? Here is a beautiful memory tip for you. Hen A has 7 eggs, but it likes to have 8 eggs to be happy. Similarly, hen B also has 7 eggs. It also loves to have 8 eggs to be happy. Therefore, they decide to share 1 egg each so that both of them can have 8 eggs. Our second question is, which bonding is mostly shown by carbon in its compound? So that's covalent bonding formed by sharing of electrons. Our third question is, why melting and boiling points of carbon compounds are very low? They form covalent bonding by sharing of electron. The forces are very weak in them. Here is a memory tip for you. A candle is made up of carbon compounds which have lots of covalent bonds which are very weak. That is why carbon compounds have low boiling point and melting points. Our fourth question is, how is the conductivity shown by carbon compounds? In general, they are poor conductors of electricity because they are not capable of forming ions. Here is a memory tip for you. So this is a simple electrical circuit in which the bulb glows. If you disconnect the circuit at any point and if you connect it again by using a covalent compound in that place, the bulb stops glowing because covalent compound cannot conduct electricity. Our fifth question is, why carbon does not form ionic compounds? So here is a memory tip for you. The carbon has to lose 4 electrons to form a cation, or it has to gain 4 electrons to form an anion. But unfortunately, both the things require huge energy, which is impossible. That is why carbon compounds do not form ionic compounds. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, click the like button and share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching.